ബ്രഹ്മശ്രീ സ്വാമി വിശ്വദാനന്ദജി, ശ്രീമത് സ്വാമി ശാരദാനന്ദജി, ശ്രീമത് സ്വാമി ചന്ദ്രാനന്ദജി, അഡ്വക്കേറ്റ് വി ജോയ്, മെമ്പർ ഓഫ് ലെജിസ്ലേറ്റീവ് അസംബ്ലി, സ്വാമി വിശാലനന്ദാജി, ലേഡീസ് ആൻഡ് ജെൻറ്റിൽമെൻ, I would like to begin by thanking His Holiness Swami Vishwaranandji for giving me this opportunity to be here on this blessed day. It is my great fortune that I am here today. It is my great fortune because I believe that Jagatguru Sri Narayana Gurudev was one of our foremost saints and apostles. The reform process which he started is something which needs to be carried forward. It is a reform process which was very important. It was very important for our religion. I am a Hindu and I believe that without reform our religion cannot progress. I believe that we need to do away with the caste system at once. I believe that there is no caste. I believe along with Jagatguru that there is no caste. God did not make any caste. All of us are one. Any distinction of caste which is there has been made not by God but by man. It has divided us, and we cannot be strong if we are divided. That is what Jagatguru Narayana Gurudev said. There is a reflection of God in all of us. We are all of us Brahmins because there is a reflection of Brahma within all of us. So all of us are the same. That is what he taught us. That is what we should learn. And unfortunately, that is not what we have learned till date in India. We have still not learnt it. There is still distinction between caste and caste. That distinction needs to be done away with. There is no difference between you and him and me or anybody else. That is something which we have to understand, which you have to understand, which I have to understand. And this is one task which remains unfinished. There has been development. We have progressed. Now, the discrimination which was there on ground of caste has reduced, has almost gone away. But it's still there. It is still there. The feeling of caste still divides us. Our freedom fighters, Mahatma Gandhi, they realized this. And Mahatma Gandhi also worked in the same direction as Jagatguru. And he also sought to remove this caste distinction. And it was because of this, because during the freedom struggle we transcended the caste distinction, that we were able to drive the British out of our country. But the work still remains unfinished. Jagatguru also taught us one more thing, that there is no need for anybody to come between us and God. There is no need for any person to come between us and God. We can pray directly to God. Earlier, it was only Brahmins who could start temples. He started temples. This is 1890, 1900. Imagine at that time when the caste system was so strong. He was sending us a message that there is no distinction, and in the eyes of God we are all equal, we are all the same, and we have a right to pray to God straight without any intermediary. That is why he also made the forms of prayer simple. He did away with all those, you know, the lot of unnecessary mantras and slokas. He made it simple. You want to talk to God? Talk to God. Talk to God as a common man. You don't need any mantra to talk to God. You just need to be pure in your heart. You don't need any sloka to talk to God. You just need to think of God. And he is there. And he taught us that there is one God. That there is no distinction between religion. Religion is also something which people have made. But there is one God. Advaita. There is one God, one human being, no caste. That is what he taught us. And that is what is relevant still today. And realize that we can't progress without education. Without gyan, we cannot know what is the right path. Education is what? It is gyan. He realized that. And he said that, okay, temples, yes, but schools. Wherever you have a temple, you must have a school. There is a story which is said that people of some college, people of some village wanted to call him to start a temple. After a lot of persuasion, he went there. But he said that, okay, see, he installed a mirror. Why did he install a mirror there? Because there is a little bit of God in every one of us. And then he said that you also start a school. Without gyan, we cannot know the true path. Without gyan, we cannot progress. He realized that as well. Without industry, we cannot progress. He realized that as well. So for a person, he was a saint. Imagine in 1890, 1900, he was so far-sighted. Now I am happy to be here because I believe in what he taught. I believe in what he said. I believe that the scourge of casteism must end if our religion is to grow strong. I am a Hindu, I believe in Hinduism, and I want Hinduism to be strong. But it can only be strong if we do away with caste. If we do away with the distinction between man and man. If we realize that all of us are equal. And all of us deserve the same respect. That is what his teaching was. And his teaching was, be a good man and you will find God. If you are good inside, you will get God, you will find God. The path to God will be clear. That's what his teaching was. That is why I am so happy to be here today. And for this, I want to thank His Holiness Swami Vishwadananda and also my friend Muralidharan, who is the Minister of State for External Affairs with me. He is my colleague. He also wanted to be here today, but he has had to go abroad because the United Nations is opening and he has to be there. We have just now removed Article 370. And he has, so Mr. Muralidharan has to stand up and defend the step and speak up for the country. Otherwise, he would have been here. But I thank him nonetheless for giving me this opportunity. As I said, I mean, it's God's grace that I am here today. And I pledge before you that I'll continue following his philosophy. I'll continue speaking out against caste and against caste discrimination. Let us all pledge what I am pledging. All of you should also pledge the same thing. Thank you very much. May Lord bless us all.